Now, we've talked about some of the changes that happen to boys.
And we've talked about some of the changes that happen with girls.
Now, we want to talk about a big topic that becomes far more interesting as you get older.
Sex.
Yes, say it again.
Sex.
If you are an adult listening to this and you think it's not the right time to bring up this topic, then feel free to skip this part.
Yeah, we'll still be here on the recording later. But if you're ready to go, let's talk about the magical world of sex.
Do, 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 do.
So what is sex?
Many of you will have known the basics about sexual intercourse for years. For others, it might be something you've only recently found out. Kids nowadays generally know more about sex at a younger age than when I was at school. I can remember being told by a friend at the age of 11. The guy who told me was a real joker. And so when he told me that to make babies, a man puts his penis into a woman's vagina, bro, I just freaked out. I just didn't believe him. I turned to someone else and said, do you know what he just said? I told him and he said, yeah, bro, that's right. You know what? I was shocked. And then all of a sudden, I got the point of a whole lot of jokes that I'd laughed at. And you know what? Never really understood.
Now, these days, because of the internet, it's easier to find out information about sex than ever before in history. And that's great, but not all information is helpful. During our lives, we've worked out things about sex and relationships that you can't learn about from the internet. Your parents probably have as well. I mean, let's face it, they've done it at least once.
So we want to take this opportunity to share with you not just information about sex, but some great wisdom around sex.
So what is sex for? Well, at a very basic level, sex is about making babies. The changes that happen to your bodies at puberty enable you to create and grow a new human being, to activate their very existence. It's a fantastic thing, the closest thing to a miracle that I've ever experienced. It's an incredible responsibility. Young teenagers of 12 or 13 or even younger are able to have sex, and the girl can get pregnant potentially and have a baby. Our bodies are physically ready to create a baby long before we are ready to be parents. And so sex is fantastic, but it's also something that deserves to be treated with a lot of respect.
It's not just our bodies that get ready for sex as we become teenagers. Our minds do as well. The same hormones that cause our sexual organs to get ready to reproduce also changes the way we think. When we were little kids, we might have had a boyfriend or a girlfriend, but it wasn't very usual, and our mates probably teased us about it. But amazingly, our ideas start to change. If you're a girl, boys start getting interesting, and boys start to become fascinated with the shape and form of girls. And sometimes they even find themselves staring. This is just a temporary stage that boys go through that starts at around about the age of 11 and lasts till you're about 92.
I've noticed that from about age 10 on, young people start talking about who's going out with who, or who likes who, or who fancies who. Though to be honest, the term going out might not mean that much at all. Possibly, girls feel more romantic feelings than boys during the young teen years. They can get crushes on boys, and those powerful emotions I talked about before that make you feel as if he's just the most wonderful person in the world, and you blush if he looks at you, and you imagine how wonderful your life would be together, what you'll name your children, and what you'll look like on your wedding day with them. Okay, sometimes we do get a little carried away. These feelings can be very powerful, and occasionally those types of feelings can develop for someone you could never actually be in a relationship with, someone famous or someone maybe much older than you. During this time in your life, your emotions may try and take control of your choices. So it's really important to remember that you have to drive your emotions rather than letting them drive you. Yep, that phys ed teacher might be absolutely gorgeous, but you need to switch your brain on. He's possibly 20 years older than you, maybe even married, and if he did fall for you, he'd be fired or go to jail.
I must admit, I've had very little experience of being a girl. In fact, when I last checked, no experience at all. But I do know that boys feel these crushes as well. Boys and girls will also feel powerful sexual feelings, a desire to touch, to kiss, to cuddle, to see their bodies, and to have sex with them. Making babies is actually the last thing on their minds. They just want the pleasure of having sex.
So here's a couple of questions for you. For our adult, how old were you when you learnt about sex?
For the child, what is sex for?